Hey guys, what's up? Time for another fragrance review. A little forward for this one. I guess I should say someone actually recognized me on 4chan, so I don't, they watch these videos, I guess. So to whoever that was, thank you, I guess. And I also got these two samples that I'm gonna do this review of from a guy in the fragrance community who wanted to remain nameless for some reason, but he knows who he is, so thank you to him for giving me these samples basically. Anyway, so I'm gonna do a couple of reviews from and I'm sure I'm gonna say these names wrong. Naomi Goodsir and like I said, I'm sure I'm gonna butcher these names. I'll just write it down. The first one I'm going to do is Bois de Axis. Dude, I'm sure I totally killed that name, but I'm gonna write it down in the description because I probably said it wrong, right? Anyway, this is the one that's supposed to smell like a barbecue kind of thing. Like, sounds very novelty-ish just from the sound of it. But top notes are tobacco and whiskey. The middle notes are cinnamon, amber, and lavender. And the base notes are oakmoss, cedar, and incense. And I can say, yeah, it smelled like a barbecue to me, basically. I think on paper it's more smoky when I tried it on paper, and I think on paper there's like some more sweetness or whatever. But on my skin, the kind of I think the foody quality of it came out a lot more, and by that I mean it kind of smelled like beef jerky, unfortunately, the first portion of it. I got a kind of a very smoky, kind of like a beef jerky kind of smell. That as it dries down, I got it kind of turns into a very, I got a lot of oak moss out of this, which just looking by Pragmatica, I know they say what notes, you know, people got the most. Like I got a lot of oak moss out of this. I got a very kind of like towards the end of more of the oak moss adding a kind of strange sort of freshness to it. So basically, a very smoky kind of oak moss kind of smell, if that makes sense. But it was kind of became a overall kind of gave me the vibe of more so than a barbecue kind of smell, kind of like charcoal after you've grilled, you know, steak or made whatever you've made, you know, kind of like the burnt charcoal kind of smell from something that you cooked. So yeah, you know, I kind of like on paper, like I said, it's more smoky and sweet, and it's not quite as foody. But you know, on my skin, because I got like a beef jerky kind of smell, and I did get a bad reaction when I wore this, actually. They did also, they thought I smelled like beef jerky, unfortunately. So I don't know how wearable I would call this. I do like appreciate the novelty factor of it though. Do you know what I mean? Just because it's interesting, because you know, you smell hundreds of fragrances and sometimes so many things they smell, you know, kind of boring or just not good. Like, this did smell interesting to me. I didn't think it was particularly wearable. I mean, maybe if it smelled on my skin like it did paper, a little more wearable, but it's still pretty novelty, I think, you know what I mean? So I don't know if I could ever justify buying a full bottle, but I guess some. It's definitely a rich people scent, I think. Novelty, like for a rich person, I think. But I mean, I think it's worth trying. Do you know what I mean? Just because it's kind of interesting. I did get that kind of for a little bit, I got that kind of that tobacco labdanum kind of smell that you smell in other fragrances as well, that kind of sweetness. But overall though, like I said, I got a lot of kind of foodiness for the first bit of the fragrance, which kind of ruined it. And then of course kind of changed into a very kind of, you know, smoky oak moss kind of smell I got, which was, you know, pleasant in its own way, not super wearable, I don't think, you know what I mean, if you're going for compliments, but interesting smelling, you know, kind of smell like a charcoal, so I do kind of get like, you know, a barbecue kind of smell. So I'll give it a try if you're into fragrances. If you're not super into fragrances, there's probably no reason to ever like smell this, you know what I mean. The next one was the one that I was excited about smelling, and that one was Or du Serail. You know what? I'm saying these names wrong. You know, the names aren't important. How we know I can't even speak English correctly half the time, but I'll write it down. I was actually, this was the one I was excited the most to smell because someone actually said it kind of smelled like Fripon, like a different kind of version of that, Fripon's 1270. And I do like that one quite a bit when I don't get a just a total butterscotch kind of smell. I don't know if I said that during my review of that one, but some of that times that one I can just smell straight butterscotch and it just is lost on me. Like I don't care to smell like that all day. But anyway, this one has a mess of notes and it has apple, red berries, mango, and sweet orange at the top. The middle notes are rum, artemisia, sage, coconut, geranium, ylang-ylang, and mate. And the base notes are labdanum, beeswax, honey, tobacco, amber, oak tree, cedar, musk, and vanilla. So that is a mess of notes, right? But you know what I mean? It sounds kind of fun. Like, I mean, and of course, I've heard that it has like a nice tropical kind of vibe as well, which kind of smells kind of, or not smells, but I should say, sounds interesting, I should say. Well, bad news for this one, guys. I've been into fragrances for a few years now, and thankfully, I haven't had any accidents, but this was my first accident. I got my little decant, little like sample thing, and I put it on my table. I tried it on paper first, and I dropped it all over my carpet. So this one, unfortunately, this one has an asterisk by it. I'm only doing this one, what it smells like on paper and my carpet. And on paper, and especially my carpet, it's so awful. It smells like a fucking mess, dude. Like, wow, it was not kind on paper or skin. So I'm gonna guess it doesn't smell that great on clothes either, if you're one of those kind of people that spray on clothes. But again, I don't know what it smells like on skin. I'm sorry, I'll have to try it again. But you know, man, dude, just a mess. Dude, my carpet smelled like crap. Like I basically took a bunch of lemon, just tried the lemon soap, just tried to scrub the crap out of it, man. I mean, it was like so strong, so awful. I mean, this is very It's very juicy. It is very tropical. It is very sweet and strong, and it's just all coming at you. And it's not bad. It's not like disgusting. Like, okay, like the smell isn't disgusting, but it could be disgusting because of just how strong it is, perhaps I should say. Not just the smell itself, if you get what I'm trying to say. But it's just so piercing strong and like strong and like it's just so much coming at you. I didn't get, you know, I was hoping to get all these things like the rum, you know, the tobacco, some of these harsher notes to kind of like balance it. But, you know, I didn't get a really lot of tobacco or anything like that on my paper or carpet. I didn't get a lot of that, dude. You know what I mean? A very super strong, super tropical kind of thing. I thought it kind of smelled like a pie, actually. It kind of reminded me of a pie, a very juicy tropical kind of like vibey pie, but imagine that the pie was not balanced, I guess you could say. Like the pie, you jammed so much into the pie, it like bursted in the oven. And not only did it burst in the oven, but you also put a bunch of like jelly jam paste all over it. I mean, it was just too much. Like I didn't get a lot of contrasting elements, unfortunately. Like I said, I was hoping for some tobacco, some of these other notes, you know what I mean? Add a little bit of harshness, you know what I mean, to balance that, but I didn't get a lot of that. On paper, like I said too, I didn't even get any really like vanilla. I didn't get anything but just this like fruit pie gone wrong vibe. Until maybe, you know, a day or so later when that's finally started dying down on the piece of paper, I could get a little bit of the vanilla. And you know, I've seen some people say that this smells kind of like back to black, I guess. And I guess, I don't think it smells like back to black, but I guess it has that kind of a fresh baby wipe vanilla, if that makes sense. It kind of has like a little bit of that kind of vanilla vibe, but I mean, you know, I had to wait over a day before I could even smell some of that on the paper. I mean, it's just so fruity and all over the place. I would actually compare, the only thing I would actually compare this to, and just because I think the pie vibe, if anyone has smelt, is it from Terre de Mez, I think? Are they the one make? Oh, the ambergris nargile or whatever. If anyone has smelled that, that has that honey, apple, cinnamon pie kind of thing. And to be honest, I don't like pie either, so put that as an asterisk to everything that I'm saying as well. I don't care for pie, it doesn't do anything for me. But I actually appreciate that one because it's just done so well. You know what I mean? The honey kind of vibe, like, I don't really like pie, but ambergris narguilé, if I was rich, you know what I mean? I might get a like a bigger decant of that just because I appreciate it for what it is. This is just, it was too fruity, too juicy. I didn't get any contrast in it. It's just like the pie exploded all over. You know what I mean? Wasn't super horny about this, but again, it wasn't on skin. Maybe it might be better. You know what I mean? Of course, like I'm thinking that, like I guess my skin picked up some of this foodie element of Bois, says whatever barbecue fragrance. That's what it was basically. Speaking of that, I know they actually have a bacon fragrance. I don't know if anyone has smelt that. I wonder if that maybe kind of smells like that one. I'm not sure. Again, that's pretty novelty as well, though, right? So anyway, again, I wasn't too horny about this last one. I do want to try it again though, just because I think I should like it, but on paper and carpet, it didn't really do anything for me. I think if that smells like it does on my skin, I think if you ever wanted a pie fragrance, I think ambergris narguilé or whatever that it is, you should probably try that one because that one is, I think it does it better. Anyway, and so yeah, that's kind of my review of that. Thanks to whoever it was that recognized me on 4chan. I don't think my fragrance reviews get a lot of views, but I guess someone recognized me from that, so that's kind of cool. And of course, thanks to the guy that sent me these, because he did that out of the goodness of his heart, I guess, and he didn't want a proper thank you, or he didn't want me to name drop him, but he knows who he is, so thanks. Thanks for watching, guys. Like, sub, subscribe. Just please don't hate. Hopefully, we'll be back with some other fragrance reviews again another day. Thanks.